I get asked quite often to talk about WildStar for various reasons, so lo and behold, today we're going to talk about this MMORPG that attempted to go completely hardcore and is definitely a big deal in the history of the MMO genre and did a lot of really unique things. WildStar was a fantasy fiction fantasy based MMORPG by Carbine Studios, which were former members of Blizzard Entertainment, and also worth noting is that many of them were involved in Diablo 2, EverQuest, City of Heroes, and Half-Life 2, and many other games, so it was an all-star team, and it was published by NCSoft. Now, you may have just heard NCSoft and you are ready to leave, you already think you know what happened, but this was a different time and place, and there is a lot to be told here, so stick with me for just a bit. WildStar was released on June of 2014, and was a subscription-based MMO. It took place in a universe where civilization had entered an intergalactic society spanning the galaxies. There were two warring factions, the Eldan and the Dominion, vying for control of worlds, and most notably, the rediscovered planet of Nexus. Now, that isn't doing the story full justice, I understand, but it's enough for a general understanding. WildStar was a persistent open-world MMO where max level was 50, and the gameplay loop consisted between questing, dungeons, and PvP, and of course, raiding. The catch to WildStar was it wanted to be the MMO that didn't hold your hand very much or care about your feelings. It was built to be hardcore, and the community was quick to tell people that whined about it that World of Warcraft was still available for them to go play instead. And this is where the rot began. But I'm getting ahead of myself just a bit. Let's talk about the innovations WildStar brought to players' ability to move around the world, for example, double jumping, sprinting, and dashing. And it was used in various ways for exploration and all those type of aspects, including a lot of gameplay scenarios such as racing and platforming puzzles. Combat was telegraphed heavily so players could learn what the telegraphs meant to avoid AoEs and various sorts of attacks. The movement mechanics came in play pretty heavy here in my opinion, and for many of the encounters, a player needed to have a mastery over dashing and sprinting to avoid damage and or wipes. Beyond that, and the general more hardcore nature of many encounters, it had all of the things you would expect from an MMORPG. There were six classes, although your race many times were tied to specific classes as built into the lore, and all of the classes could DPS pretty well, but only some could be a tank or a healer. Now beyond the classes, there were also four paths the player decided upon and were leveled up differently than the classes, and paths went to level 30. Now these paths were very interesting because it was basically telling the MMO what type of content you would enjoy. Are you a soldier, meaning you are all about slaughtering the enemy, meaning you would get assassination, demolition, and conquering type missions? Or are you more of an explorer type, discovering the unknown with abilities to help you, such as safe fall, air brakes, and translocation, and your missions would look more like cartography, expeditions, surveillance, or tracking? Or perhaps you're more of a scientist, with the ability to summon your group, make portals, and your missions would look more like archaeology, biology, botany, cataloging, and diagnostics. And then finally, are you more of a settler, taming the lands with abilities like campfire, summon mailbox, and summon vendors, crafting stations, and with missions more about expansion, defense, services, and supplies? And between these four paths, WildStar set it up so that you could be rewarded for playing the way you wanted to enjoy WildStar, and to be honest, although based off of a concept from the 90s, hadn't really been fully realized or seen before in one package until WildStar, and not really utilized in this way since, at least at the time of this recording. Typically, an MMO decides which of these players is accommodating, maybe picks a few of them or a couple of them and builds their world and game off of that concept. Whereas WildStar was giving that freedom to the player. Very, very interesting stuff here. WildStar also had player housing where you could own a sky plot, where you could have sockets where you decided what you wanted, crafting spots, mines, exploration shafts, and more. Many people thought the housing in WildStar was completely awesome as it even expanded into allowing communities of housing where they could combine their plots into one much larger plot. Now, before we go any further, though, let's hear from our sponsor and then we'll continue. I want to give a major shout out to the members of Napalm. I could not do this without you. You are the sponsors of this channel, and I thank you for your contribution, allowing me to keep making videos on MMOs, RPGs, and of course, puppets. If you are interested in becoming a member of Napalm, please click the join button down below. It is greatly appreciated. And a very special shout out to the Lord Words of Napalm, Bounty Code, We Tote Bitcoins, Jared Woodhouse, and Dimelos. Thank you for your highest tier membership. Now, the PvP was designed to allow players to fight all over the open world of the game, but also offered arenas, battlegrounds, and depending on the type, could range between 2 versus 2 all the way up to war plots, which were 30 versus 30. Raiding was the main attraction, of course, to WildStar for many of the player base, and this is where the hardcore aspect really kicked into full gear. Players would do 20-man raids, which were instance-based, and progress their way to the massive 40-man raids, in which the mechanics would pick up pace, and although telegraphed, the combinations of mechanics at once left many of the community in the dust. Now, I think this is a fairly standard practice in MMOs, and although it might have owned its fair share in the demise of WildStar, it is far from the full story. The community surrounding the raiding scene, many of the times, came from World of Warcraft, and there was an extreme amount of elitism running rampant, and many players who normally could have continued to get better over time were told to go play World of Warcraft, and you know what? Many of them did. While leveling, new players would see and hear things that let them know that if they weren't top of the line, they might not belong in the in-game gameplay at all. This is certainly of note, as many players report on feeling this way or seeing this type of behavior. One can't blame the rating system for being hard completely on all of this. One can't completely blame the community either, although they shared a large portion of the blame. Perhaps the root is, though, that the developers and publishers were pushing this hardcore mentality that bled out into the player base and certainly affected their behavior. WildStar was forced to go free to play as the population began to dwindle and nothing could save it. It began to bleed users until they eventually shut it down in 2018. Now that I've given a fair amount of history and explained that what WildStar generally was, let's talk about what happened to it. Of course, the community and toxic behavior had major effects, but there are various aspects to consider here. Let's look at the draw of WildStar to begin with. Initial hype was based on that the game was being developed by previous Blizzard staff. And although Blizzard has dipped into sci-fi before and will continue to in the future, it's worth mentioning that the specific demographic for an MMO at that time would have been interested in fantasy. And although WildStar had some of that, for fantasy fans to see motorbikes and space travel and guns as weapons, it's a turnoff for many. I can absolutely promise you, for an example, that many people clicked off of this entire video at the intro when they seen all the sci-fi stuff because they might have been interested in what WildStar was all about, then seen that and immediately left with a general understanding of why they never played WildStar to begin with. There is nothing wrong with making a sci-fi MMO, but when your general MMO player base you're hyping from the get-go is World of Warcraft fans and looking for something like that, it's a bit of a turnoff for so many people to change the general feeling of the universe, in my opinion, to that degree. So I do believe that at least played a small part. And then there is the graphic style that they chose to go with. Very Pixar feeling, which makes sense as it's in the neighborhood of the World of Warcraft art style. And this art style ages really well, I have to say as well. So I can understand it, but once again, it's a sci-fi game and targeted as hardcore, yet it looks like a children's movie by Disney. That's just not a very good cohesive combination, once again, in my opinion. And let's talk more about the hardcore thing, shall we? So at first, the game is pretty simple, and somebody's going to leave a comment because I talked about this earlier about it being hardcore. I thought the game was easy. Well, yeah, the game did start out very simple, and it was kind of a cakewalk, and the buildup, though, to the harder content was just too steep of a learning curve. It didn't just slowly get harder. It just kind of smashes you into the hardcore after so long of being very softcore. And when you hit the hardcore parts, and when the game is drawing their audience from World of Warcraft, in majority at least, and then those players come over to try your game and feel underpowered and like they aren't good at it by late game, many will just say, oh well, I'm good at WoW, I'm gonna go back to what I'm good at. Especially, they will think this when the community treats them poorly as they are trying to grasp and get good. And then if you make it to max level but aren't good, or don't have the confidence to keep trying, there was little left for you to do, which will cause sub cancels for sure. There were also some issues with the game itself, bugs and poor performance, especially on AMD, quest hubs like crazy, many people feeling that PvP was a disaster with rampant cheating on the systems in play. On top of this, you can call me a conspiracy theorist if you want, but it's pretty well documented in my opinion that this is true. WoW was still really strong and they had people go out into other MMOs they felt were competition and remind people in general chat, guild chats, etc. about World of Warcraft, tickling their nostalgia and making them want to go back. This happened, and it was very effective during that time period in working for many, many, many years. All of these things combined meant that soon the "this game is dead" feelings and talks began, and it is a death spiral from there. New players didn't feel the game had a future and didn't want to invest the time, and players didn't want to return to a dead MMO, and existing players, not all but many, took a look around and went back to their previous MMORPG. WildStar was an MMO with big, ambitious ideas, and many were absolutely fantastic, and the lovers of WildStar will never forget the memories they had and will always wonder what could have been. But ultimately, WildStar now rests in the expanding graveyard of MMORPGs that didn't make it, and although there is hopes that the WildStar emulation server might give you some hope for the fans, it is still in infancy at the time of this recording. It's playable, as in you can run around and play around, but most of the mechanics of the game are not working yet. If you're interested in checking it out, though, it is called WildStar Nexus Forever, and I will have a link to their website in the description down below. Now it is your turn to tell me about your memories in WildStar, what reasons you think caused it to fail, and your opinions in the comments. Drop me a like if you enjoyed this video, and if you want MMO content and RPG content, please consider subscribing for more. And until next time, my friends, God bless and happy gaming.